Hey everyone, this is Johnny from Filmora, here to empower your inner video creator. What do tech ads, slam poetry videos, and lyric videos all have in common? They all use motion graphics. Motion graphics, or MoGraph for short, is the art of taking graphics and putting them in motion in fun and exciting ways. We animated those motion graphics entirely in Filmora 9 and Filmora Pro. And today we're gonna show you how we did it so you can go out and make your very own killer motion graphics. So, let's get started. I made this first part of our motion graphics in Filmora 9. Here's how I tackled it. So the first thing you want to do when working on narrated motion graphics or lyric videos is to look at your audio. It'll be important to identify when different words are being said. Let's zoom in and take a closer look at that. If we really want to lay it out, we can create new markers by hitting the M key every time a new word appears. So let's head over to titles, and we want to grab a simple centered one for this example. I'll grab this one here and drag it into our timeline and double click on it. I want to get rid of this smaller title, so let's hit advanced and click on that title and then hit the trash icon. Next, let's take this larger text and change it to motion graphics. Under customize, let's hit the center icon beside position to center our title. Finally, let's give this phrase a cooler animation. Let's go to animation and select typewriter. Let's hit OK. Let's make it go by a little bit faster by trimming down the clip a bit. There we go. Motion graphics. Next, let's make a similar title for when the word MoGraph comes in by copying our current title and pasting it later in the timeline. Let's move it to our marker that we made. First, I'll change the text. And now I want to animate it with a different technique. Instead of using one of these animations, I'm going to go under animation and select no animation. Next, let's go to our effects and under shake, drag chaos 2 onto the track above our MoGraph title. Next, let's bring down our effect a little bit by double clicking it, bringing down the frequency a bit and unchecking RGB separate. Now we have a nice shaking animation for MoGraph. Finally, let's use a simpler technique for our other words. Let's copy our MoGraph title and let's animate it on a track above everything else. Let's write the word or for this title and select a less bold font and move it up a bit. And then let's duplicate this layer again and write for short. And let's make sure the word or goes all the way on a track above our chaos effect and move the for short text onto a higher track as well. Motion graphics, or MoGraph for short. All right, that sounds pretty good. And last but not least, let's grab some music in to accompany my talking. All right, there we go. And that's how we did the first section of motion graphics in Filmora 9. Next, we're going to show you how we did the second section in Filmora Pro. Yeah. Filmora Pro really shines when it comes to motion graphics because of its versatile text and its keyframing features. Now, if you're not familiar with keyframing, I'd recommend you check out our Animation 101 tutorial first before you go into this. So just like we did in Filmora 9, we'll use our audio waveform as a guide to where we should have our words come in. We can create and add text in Filmora Pro by clicking the text tool in the viewer panel and clicking directly in our viewer. Let's write out our first line. We can change up the font in the text panel and center our line by going to the layout panel and clicking this button under alignment. Let's say we want to animate this line so that each word comes in as it's being said. An easy way to do this is to duplicate our text so that there are as many objects as there are words. For this first piece of text, let's highlight everything except for the first word and click this square to make it all transparent. We'll go to our next object and make everything except for the second word transparent and do the same for the rest of these objects. Next, let's line them all up on different tracks so that each one comes in when a new word is said. And now all of our words should come in as they're being said. Is the art of taking graphics and... Let's fast forward and say we've used this technique on the rest of the lines of text. We've also placed these really nice bold words, graphics and motion, to really emphasize them. That said, let's animate these two words further. First, for the word motion, let's animate this word so that it comes in from off the bottom of the frame using keyframes. With our motion text selected, let's go to our controls tab and create a position keyframe at the beginning. And another one 5 keyframes in. Going back to our first keyframe, let's take our position's Y value and drag it so that our text drops off at the bottom of the frame. Finally, let's right-click the second keyframe and select Smooth In, and under Clip Properties, check the Motion Blur button. If you want to see this motion blur while you're editing, you'll want to go to your playback quality and set it to Final. Now we have a nice and impactful animation. Next, for the word graphics, let's have it swing in with a 3D looking effect. Let's grab our perspective warp effect and make sure that the warp X and warp Y are set to no. Next, go to latitude, and like with our last animation, create a couple keyframes. Let's go to the first keyframe and slide the latitude value so that the object is swung all the way up. And set the second keyframe to smooth in. Finally, let's animate our opacity at the beginning so that it fades in from nothing at the very start. And let's take a look at that. Finally, let's move on to this last part.
In fun and exciting ways,
I want to add a more playful animation to the word fun. What we'll do for this one is go to the Fun Text Objects Scale property and create a keyframe right at the start. A second one about 5 frames in, and a third one about another 5 frames in. Let's set our first keyframe to 0, and our second one to 105%. Finally, let's turn our middle keyframe into a smooth keyframe, and our last one into a smooth in keyframe. Now we get this really playful bounce effect. Rinse and repeat for the word exciting, and you've got our final product.
So that's how to create motion graphics in Filmora 9 and Filmora Pro. Motion graphics is something you really need to practice and experiment with to get better at. If you want to experiment for yourself, which I highly recommend you do, you can try out Filmora 9 and Filmora Pro for free by heading to filmora.wondershare.com. I hope this video was helpful and it inspires you to make your very own motion graphics and lyric videos. See y'all next time. Keep creating.